Dear students, now let me discuss about kinetic friction. Okay, so the kinetic friction will only arise when the body is in motion. If the body is at rest and up to a limiting friction, up to a limiting value, that is a limiting frictional force, the static frictional force, and the limiting frictional force is the maximum value of static frictional force. Now, what about kinetic friction? What actually mean by kinetic friction? Or when this kinetic friction is arise? The kinetic friction is arise only when the object is in moving. So if the object is moving with an acceleration a, suppose, and a force F is applied, then obviously along the backward direction a frictional force will arise, and this frictional force is called as kinetic frictional force, that is denoted by Fk. Okay, and this kinetic frictional force will also proportional to n. Okay, so this will always be same. So Fk will also be proportional to n. And now if we talk about the coefficient of friction, then it is denoted as mu k. So it will be now mu k into n. So this mu k is nothing but the coefficient of friction, coefficient of kinetic friction, coefficient of kinetic friction, coefficient of kinetic friction. And this is the kinetic frictional force, obviously. This is the kinetic frictional force. So the dependency will be same. Kinetic frictional force, frictional force. Another thing is very important, that the kinetic friction Fk will always be less than Fl, or you can say F simply, obviously Fl. Okay, so after movement, when the body is in motion, then the frictional force will be decreases. You can, and this is the experimental result, you can find it, that the kinetic frictional force will always be less than the limiting frictional force. So in that context, you can say that the mu k will also be less than mu s, that is static friction. Okay, so this is the thing that you have to remember. And in the category of kinetic friction, there is another thing that you can say, it is rotational friction, or you can say the rolling friction. Okay, rolling friction, the best word is you can use rolling friction. Rolling friction, okay, this is also important thing. And when rolling friction is appear, suppose this is ground, and our object is, object of radius r. Okay, so suppose this is an object of radius r. Now if this object is rotated, then a frictional force will arise along this direction. Though the rotational rolling friction will be more complicated, I will discuss the about this rolling friction in great detail on the chapter rotational motion. Okay, so it can be of backward direction, it can be of forward direction, there are various cases, but for simplicity here you can say the frictional force is in backward direction. But there are various cases when the frictional force may be of backward direction, may be of forward direction. Okay, but here just I want to know about the origin of, there is an existence of frictional force which is called actually rolling friction. Okay, and this rolling frictional force is depend not only n, but is inversely proportional to 1 by r. Okay, so this rolling friction Fr is nothing but mu r into n divided by r. So this is all about the rolling friction. Okay, so in kinetic friction, you can give this rolling friction also, or you can take this rolling friction as a different kind of friction. One is static friction, another is kinetic friction, another is rolling friction. But you can also tell this rolling friction in the category of kinetic friction. Okay, so if you talk about this rolling friction now, see, rolling frictional force is also less than the kinetic frictional force. So if you talk about this three frictional force in a single equation, then you can write that the limiting frictional force is obviously greater than the kinetic frictional force, and so it is obviously greater than the rolling frictional force. So Fr is less than Fk, is less than Fl. Okay, or you can say mu r is less than mu k, is less than mu l. Okay. Thank you.